Good evening to you. I'm Hubert Gregg, knocking. Laurie, the wee leading girl in Oklahoma, sang, "Never have I asked an August sky where has last July gone," which would make her a poor member of the Friday Club, where we know the answer to the passing of time. It's in the bag we carry around on our shoulder to dip into for yesterday comfort in today's tumult. The reason we're able to say a Friday's one to another, thanks for the memory. Hello again from the Friday Club Square Chair. We open with a familiar classic, Dick Haymes, in the Rodgers and Hammerstein song that lit the sky in the movie State Fair.
Singing, the moon is flying high, and somewhere a bird who is bound he'll be heard is throwing his heart at the sky.
It's a grand night for singing.
The stars are bright above, the earth is aglow, and to add to the show, I think I am falling in love. The moon, maybe it's more than the birds, maybe it's more than the sight of the night and a light too lovely for words. Maybe it's more than the earth, shiny and silvery blue. Maybe the reason I'm feeling this way has something to do with you.
It's a grand night for singing. The moon is flying high, and somewhere a bird who is bound he'll be heard is throwing his heart at the sky.
Oh, it's a grand night for singing. The stars are bright above, the earth is aglow, and to add to the show, I think I am falling in love.
Dick Haymes in a song from State Fair. As Jean DePaul and Johnny Mercer did in Seven Brides, Rodgers and Hammerstein wrote the words and music as a movie score. Not, we must acknowledge, as successfully, but no matter. June Batchelor, thank you for writing to me from your attractive address near Gatehouse of Fleet, Kirkcudbrightshire. Excellent list that includes a well-loved pair of vaudevillians. George Burns, comedian turned film star actor in much later life, hoped to make a century in years. He spoke of playing the London Palladium on his 100th. Alas, he died not more than a hole or two before playing his parting shot. His enchanting wife, Gracie Allen, preceded him by many years. Here they are back together for the Friday Club.
Well, I guess I'll be going home now.
Going home? I'll take you home in my car.
Oh, no, thank you. I'm too tired. I'd rather walk.
That's a very good answer.
But if you like, you can walk home with me.
Yes, I'll walk home with you. I'll walk home if you give me a kiss. I'll take you home.
Well, if you take me home, I'll give you a kiss.
But just a minute. Before I take you home, I would like to find out whether or not your mother is home.
She is, but my father wouldn't let you kiss my mother. I'd mend your hose and fix your clothes. That's what I do for you. Do you believe me?
I do.
I'd cook your favorite dish, cabillaud, a fish or Irish stew. Do you believe me?
I do.
And mother dear would visit us 6 months of every year. My mother knows just how to mind her business, never fear. She's not like other mothers, she's a perfect little dear. Do you believe me?
I'm through. Yum da dum da dum da dum da dee da 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 dum.
We're dancing now. You can't see this, and it's lovely too. Right now, Miss Allen is kicking the back of her head. Maybe that's the trouble with her. You know, I think you're very smart.
Yes.
Smart girl. You're smart. Name 3 different kinds of nuts.
Walnuts and chestnuts.
That's 2.
And forget-me-nuts.
Da-dum-da-doo, da-da-dum-dum.
I'm kind of smart myself.
Yes?
I was born in New York.
Oh, yeah. Funny things happened in London, too.
Do you like to love?
No.
Do you like to kiss?
No.
What do you like?
Lamb chops.
You're too smart for one girl.
Oh, I'm more than one.
More than one.
Yes. My mother has a picture of me when I was 2.
Lovely. This is the finish. You've missed the dance.
Goodbye.
A memory of the delight brought to us by George Burns and his wife, Gracie Allen. I'm putting your letter aside, June Batchelor. Your lists are too good not to deserve other dippings. When I played the extraordinary Stella group singing about blackstrap molasses, I confess to not knowing quite what the mixture was. 2 letters arrived to help. Mrs. Joyce McBurney, who write from Ilkley. Dear Hubert Gregg, I'm enclosing a label from a jar of molasses, which I bought some time ago from a health food shop for a particular recipe. We hated it, so the jar has been lingering at the back of my cupboard since 1995. So, what were the stars up to in recommending it? Maybe you have the answer. Arthur Shenton in Eastbourne. You sent a photocopy of an entry in Webster's Dictionary, which reads, blackstrap molasses. Molasses remaining after maximum extraction of sugar from the raw product and used chiefly as a constituent of cattle feed and as a source of ethyl alcohol. So, Groucho, Danny, Schnozzle and Co. may have been skunk drunk in song. A big red apple, if you can tell who is singing here.
You made my romance sublime. Now it's time to fly. For the stars have fled from the heavens. The moon's deserted the hill. And the sultry breeze that sang in the trees is suddenly, strangely still. It's done. Little dream, it's done. So bid me a fond farewell. We've both had our fun. Was it Romeo or Juliet who said when about to die, love is not all peaches and cream, little dream. Goodbye. Was it Romeo or Juliet who said when about to die, love is not all peaches and cream, little dream, goodbye.
goodbye. Cole Porter wrote it as part of the score for the musical Oh, Mistress Mine, which starred the enchanting Yvonne Printemps. The singer who may have amazed you as he did me, Douglas Fairbanks Jr. What on earth did you think he was doing? Last sennight, I played you an interview recorded by Mary Ellis, which was a welcome gift from you, Maurice Robson, gramophone record historian in Huddersfield. This week, from the same kind source, Jessie Matthews, recorded in Hobart, Australia in June 1953.
This first song of yours, Jessie, isn't it Out of the Good Companion?
That's right. Let me give my happiness to you.
Let's see, who was in it with you?
Edmund Gwen, John Gielgud, Nettie Glynn, Archie Bascom, and Dickie Dolman.
Anything special do you remember about this film?
Yes. Yes, I have one very special memory, one very precious memory. It was that King George V, who was attending his first talkie, he saw the premiere with Queen Mary, and at the end of the film, I was very thrilled because the Marchioness of Londonderry tapped Queen Mary on the shoulder, and she got up and came to the edge of the box and waved her hand to me with a little circular movement that we all know so well. And I curtsied as best I could with all the people around me. And then she tapped King George V on the shoulder, and he also came to the edge of the box and raised his hat to me. And I tried to curtsy again and found myself blushing.
A memory of Jessie Matthews, a surprising song, I thought, claiming that happiness was synonymous with success. Unless you mean success in many forms, perfect love, for instance. One of the peak moments in my theatre going happened at the Palace Theatre in London when I booked early to see Maurice Chevallier in his solo evening. It was magic.
Paris, je t'aime, je t'aime, je t'aime, avec ivresse, comme une maîtresse, tu m'oublieras bien vite, et pourtant, mon cœur est tout chaviré, en te quittant. Je peux te dire qu'avec ton sourire, tu m'as pris l'âme, ainsi qu'une femme. Tout en moi est à toi pour toujours. Paris, je t'aime,
puits d'amour. Paris, je t'aime, je t'aime, je t'aime, je t'aime. Mais voyons, vite que je te dis que je t'aime. Allons, pour les caresses de mille maîtresses, elles m'oublieront bien vite. Et pourtant, moi de leurs baisers, je me souviendrai bien longtemps. L'une après l'une, la blonde et la brune m'ont fait sans phrase goûter mille extases. Je te jure que je t'appartiens pour toujours. Paris, je t'aime et comment d'amour.
The great Maurice Chevallier, loving his hometown. My turn to dazzle you with the expert help of Gordon Langford at the piano.
I've no wish to be clinical. You have gone and there's an end. But if I could be suitably cynical, I'd be more at ease, my friend. If I hadn't got a sentimental heart, I could forget you. If I hadn't got a sentimental heart, I'd know my way. If I hadn't got a sentimental feeling for the old enchanted years, then I wouldn't have a reason to remember them with tears. We decided that we'd better call it off and start a new life. But it wasn't quite so easy when we came to say goodbye. Now I wouldn't be confessing every minute of the day, it's you I'm thinking of, if I hadn't got a sentimental heart that's still in love. If I couldn't write a sentimental song, I would be tongue-tied. If I couldn't write a sentimental song, I'd lose my mind. Oh, a song about the weather, or the more we are together, will win the world's applause. But I'd rather write a ballad about a girl some guy adores. If you want a rousing song to win elections, I'm the wrong lad. For politically, I hardly know my left hand from my right. But if you're in love or out of love or frantically, romantically, you don't know where you're at, then for you I'll write a soulful song in just 2 seconds flat.
A song from me to you. Thank you, Gordon. Adelaide Hall it was who told me about Art Tatum, who was an accompanist for some time. The art of Tatum, a much-used phrase, was astonishing. When other greats like Waller heard him for the first time, they were unable to believe their ears. This next performance is one of my favourites, the T for Two, in which he changes key, moving up and down as he plays one chorus. If you don't know, prepare to be unbelieving.
Thank you.
Art Tatum's classic Tea for Two. What to close? An item from a smashing new 3-CD set of Al Boley. June Batchelor, he is on the list you sent me from Kakubrishire, and to which I promised a return visit. He appears too on your terrific list, Eileen Stevens in Greenford, Middlesex. Writing materials should be at the ready. The overall title is The Al Boley Story. The subtitle reads, A Feast of 76 Sides by the legendary troubadour, spanning the years 1928 to 1941, which, of course, was the year Al died in the German Blitz. Each CD has a title, The Formative Years, 1928 to 32, UK to the USA and back again, 1932 to 38, and The Final Years, 1938 to 41. From this last, I thought you might like the song Irving Berlin wrote for us in the dark days of 41.
It's a lovely day tomorrow. Tomorrow is a lovely day. Come and feast your tear-dimmed eyes on tomorrow's clear blue skies. If today your heart is weary, if every little thing looks gray, just forget your troubles and learn to say, tomorrow is a lovely day. It's a lovely day tomorrow. Tomorrow is a lovely day. Come and feast your tear-dimmed eyes on tomorrow's clear blue skies. If today your heart is weary, if every little thing looks gray, just forget your troubles and learn to say, tomorrow is a lovely day.
The always unmistakable voice of Al Boley singing Irving Berlin, an item from the new 3-shaving mirror set of 76 of Al's performances. Ask for AMBX123. AMBX123. Well, that's the agenda for tonight. My thanks, as ever, to my producer, Roy Oakeshott, for his diligent pilotry. The Friday Club will be on the air again in a sennight when, Deo Valente, I shall be in the square chair. I look forward to greeting you personally, which I may do only if you pen me a few anyone doings accompanied but not linked to a few anything buys. Until we re-meet, this is Hubert Gregg saying, harking back to Chevallier, in late life he declared, what keeps me at the top of my line is to be alone on the stage. I've got to be satisfied to be Maurice Chevallier, and I have been for a very long time. But now I must begin to think of the problem of my exit. It is so important for me to leave the table before I end up under it. His solo performances continue to take him about the globe until one night at the Théâtre des Champs-Élysées, at the end of a superb evening that had a packed house standing and applauding as though into infinity, he announced, you have just seen the last recital I will ever do on a stage anywhere. His problem was solved. He made his exit. Time to make mine. Just for tonight, I hope. As the comedian in the Gay Cadets on Bournemouth Beach used to say, I live at Hope Brothers. For the nonce, this is Hubert Gregg, broadcasting on 88 to 91 FM, Wireless 2 from the BBC in London, England, saying au revoir to you.